Hi, my dear students. Welcome back to Mastermind Classroom. I am Soumya Swan. Today, I am going to discuss about the needs and wants, the business concept, and about the marketplace. Okay, let's start the lesson. Okay, what's a need and a want? A need is basically the compulsory things that we need to fulfill for our survival. As an example, we can take food. If we take another examples, food, education, clothing, houses, those are the needs that we need to fulfill to our survival. And when it comes to the wants are the ways that we gonna fulfill our needs. If we take examples, as I mentioned earlier, the food is a need, and the want will be the ways that we prefer to fulfill the need of us. The food is the need, and the want may be noodles, a rice, roti. There are a lot of wants under the food that we can take. Okay, there are differences between the needs and wants. Let me discuss about the differences between the need and a want. Need are limited because we can count the need. We can count the needed that we having. We can say food, education, clothing, housing. Those are the main needs that we need to fulfill. But the needs we can count with our fingers. But the need are compulsory to fulfill because we have to fulfill that need requirement. Maybe it different to vary to one to one, but by the end of the day we need to fulfill our need, and the needs are common to everyone. The needs are common. The food. Okay, let's discuss about the differences of wants. The wants are unlimited. As I told earlier, the needs are unlimited. There are a lot of ways that we can fulfill our food requirement, and there are a lot of ways that we can fulfill our education requirement. As that, the wants are unlimited, and the wants are not compulsory to fulfill for the survival. If we just take a poor family, if the food is the need, but there are no any necessity of eating a burger. They can eat potatoes, okay, according to their wealthiness. By the way, the wants, the way we gonna fulfill our need is not compulsory. There is no any necessity of eating noodles. There are not any necessity of eating fried rice, okay. So, and the wants are vary to person to person, because at this moment I am hungry, but I want to eat noodles, and maybe you are hungry too, but you don't want the noodles, you want to eat a burger. And another person want to eat rice. Because of that, the wants are vary to everyone, and the wants are wants can create by a business. Maybe because of the features that the product having, maybe because of the experience that they giving, the satisfaction, because of all those things, the businesses can create the wants among the customer. Okay, let's discuss about the business. What a business is, what do you think? Simply, a business is a process of production, distribution, selling and services that will supposed to fulfill the customer's needs and wants. As examples for the business, we can take a supermarket, a hospital. They also doing a business. The business are based on exchange and selling, because the business is always trying to sell their product to customers, and the customers give the money for the product, and the business give the product for the money. Because of the when it come to market, the market is the place where the seller and the buyer meets to fulfill their requirements of need and want. Nowadays there are two parts of market. One is physical market, the shops and the showrooms. Those all are the physical market that we can visit to fulfill our need and want requirement. And there are electronic market and the online market too. We can purchase a product, as you know, we can purchase a product through online. There are many platform, famous platform that we can use to purchase online products. Some are Alibaba and AliExpress and Dara's, etc. We can take as the main and famous online platform that we can purchase. Okay, let's discuss about the product. What do you call about as a product? What do you call as a product? The product may be anything that we can offer to the marketplace that will fulfill the need and want of the customers. As examples, we can take soap, we can take clothes, we can take lecturing. Those all are products, and the products are basically, we can divide to two categories. The very first one is good and the second one is service. Okay, let's give some introduction to goods and service. The goods are the material things that we can purchase from the market. As examples, we can referring to tables, televisions, books. Those all are, we can talk about many examples for your easy to understanding. I am telling one or two examples. When it comes to service, the service is a facility that offering by a business to fulfill the need and the wants of the customers. As examples, we can take lecturing, consulting as services. And let's discuss about the differences between a good and a service. The goods are touchable. We can touch the goods. We can touch a table. We can touch a spoon. We can touch a book. The goods can touch, but the service we can't touch. can we touch the we can touch the lecturer but we can't touch the lecture we can't touch the lecture as simple as that and the product can divide from the manufacturer we can take the soap to our home from the manufacturer but the service we can't divide the service from that person who providing it can you take the lecture can you take the lecture of the lecturer to your home can you take that no you can't separate the service from the person who providing it and the product can store and the good can store we can store the soap bar in anywhere at our home maybe the kitchen maybe in the something in a box or somewhere else we want to keep it but the service we can't store we have to consume it while the provider providing it to us okay and the goods we can transfer the ownership we can transfer the we can give the money to the value of the product and we can take the ownership of the good but in the service we can only consume the service but we can't take that ownership of the service okay we'll meet up with the new videos of business studies and don't forget to stay tuned to many educational videos at Mastermind Classroom thank you